commission's scope be expanded given in light of the NSICOP report? Do you think that the commissioner should now have access to these documents and be able to look at them?
Well, I think the whole commission should have access to the documents they've requested. I think that the government should listen to, respond to Justice Hogue's request for documents. A number of the documents she has received have been redacted. We are concerned about that. We think that she needs access to all the documents in order to come to conclusions in her second report. I would note that the process is in place at the public inquiry to protect national security. In the conduct of the first part of this inquiry, it's clear that nothing injurious to national security has been released. So I think whatever reason the government has for not handing over documents or redacting documents that have been given to the commission isn't living up to the spirit of the terms of reference, which was to allow Justice Hogue to get to the bottom of the foreign interference threats in our last two elections.
What about with NSICOP? Like all of the documents they've now seen about, you know, MPs specifically being implicated, who they are, should those be handed over to her? Should she be allowed to incorporate that as part of the broader inquiry? Like to expand her scope is what I'm saying, based on what NSICOP has said.
Yeah, she's got her terms of reference, which all the parties agreed to. The government needs to hand over all the documents that she has requested. And needs to hand over information that has been redacted in the documents she has already received. And that's what we are calling on the government to do. Thank you.
I have to run.
We're seeing just a rising level of threat and harassment against all level of public officials, not just members of parliament. I've talked to school board officials, people working in small towns. I talked to a doctor at a court of practice because of online harassment and threats of violence. And we need to take these issues seriously. It's not simply a threat to a person, but it's really a threat to democracy. So when I found out that a case where we had all the evidence of threat and harassment and threat of violence, the evidence was lost and the case thrown out. It's like, at what point are we going to get serious about this issue?
What tools are needed? I mean, in this case, there's obviously a problem within the judicial system. Do police need more tools? Like, what's the gap here?
I think we're just trying to find our way in a sea of increasing threat and harassment that is unlike anything we've ever seen in Canada. There's a number of steps, I believe, that have to be taken. The House here in Parliament have to, I think, do a better job of being, working with police, working with Crown prosecutors. Right now, individual MPs who are being threatened with sometimes serious violence against them, their staff, their families, they're dealing with it on their own. I know many MPs who've dealt with stuff much worse than me who don't want to go public. They don't want to draw attention to themselves. But we need to also be able to track and have some kind of, I think, public record of people who go online regularly and make death threats. That's not acceptable in a democracy.
I hear you when you say that this is a systemic issue, and obviously we've heard from a number of MPs and public figures for years now, but just on a personal level, what was it like when you heard the news that this case was being stayed?
I was really disappointed. One of the reasons that we took charges with this individual is that we had been told that he had been making threats against other people in public life who don't have the privilege, don't have the resources that I do. And I felt that by taking this on and sending a clear message, you just can't call public offices and threaten people. I was disappointed that it didn't happen because I'm afraid if we don't start getting serious about this, someone is going to get hurt.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Is the committee done with studying this bill?
Well, tomorrow is the deadline, June the 7th, where it has to be reported back to the House. I've made several efforts, including most recently this week, to seek a 30 sitting day extension because we've only really had one meeting where we heard from witnesses. So the answer to your question is yes. Essentially, when tomorrow passes, the bill is going to be reported back to the House without having had a proper study.
What do you make of that?
I think it's a dereliction of duty. I think we owe it to Canadians to hear from witnesses on both sides of this. It's a very contentious bill. I understand the underlying nature of the bill. We do need to protect children from seeing harmful content online. But at the same time, we also have a number of people who've expressed very deep concerns about the age verification technology, the privacy concerns. We even had the privacy commissioner himself come before our committee and said he was not satisfied with the way the bill was currently written and even suggested amendments. But unfortunately, the Conservatives seem to have blocked every single attempt that the committee has had to take a deep dive into this bill and to search for viable amendments.
Given this is getting reported back to the House, is this something the NDP can support, the bill?
I'm going to be having a conversation with my caucus next week, so stay tuned on that.
What are you going to be telling your caucus? Because I think the NDP initially said, you know, we need to study this, we have to protect children, but given, what is your message going to be to your caucus colleagues when it comes to what should we say about this piece of legislation?
Right now I'm working with my House Leader's office because there may be an avenue, a procedural avenue, for us to suggest some report stage amendments. So we're trying to see if that's feasible. But again, I was hoping to have my amendments to this bill informed by witness testimony. So I really have to start doing some work on this next week with my House Leader's office to see what might be feasible at report stage.
Am I correct in understanding, so this bill is going to go back to the House. Once it's back in the House, if the House votes on it, is that law? Am I wrong in this one? Am I correct in understanding? Because this is a Senate bill.
Correct. But if we had a report stage amendment to it, then it would have to go to the Senate, so the Senate could consider an amendment. But if it was not amended in the House, then it would go to the Governor General for royal assent.
Okay. Thank you.
You're very welcome.